Here we study the variation of photocurrent with the collector plate potential for different frequencies of incident radiation. Now here we are taking that monochromatic light which is incident having a same intensity in all cases, but we are changing the frequency. By changing the frequency and with the potential of the collector plate, how does photocurrent changes we are going to study. Now from the graph it is clear that as we increase the positive potential, as we discussed in the previous topic, as we increase the positive potential of collector plate, the photocurrent increases, becomes maximum at a particular positive potential. Beyond this, if you increase the positive potential further, there is no increase in the maximum photocurrent, called saturation current. Now, as we increase the negative potential given to the collector plate, the photocurrent gradually decreases, and at a particular minimum negative voltage, it becomes zero, that is called stopping potential. Now what we are doing here, just we are increasing the frequency of the incident radiation, keeping intensity same. We are keeping same intensity for the incident radiation. Now we are increasing the frequency. As we increase the frequency, then what happens? The kinetic energy of electrons will be increased. For a metal surface, the work function is constant, means the minimum energy required to eject the electrons is constant. Now, except this work function, the remaining energy is given to the maximum kinetic energy of the electrons. As we increase the frequency, the energy of photon will be increased, and here the work function is constant. The remaining energy given to the electrons as a kinetic energy will be increased. Means as we increase the frequency, the maximum kinetic energy of the electrons will be increased. As maximum kinetic energy of electrons increases, we know that here the maximum kinetic energy of electrons is equal to AV naught. If the maximum kinetic energy of electrons increases, then the stopping potential also increases here. Now, here it is clear that here we increased frequency from nu 1 to nu 2. This is the graph drawn for a particular intensity and frequency nu 1. Now we increase the frequency at the same intensity. We didn't change the intensity here. Now if we increase the frequency, as frequency increased, energy of photons increased. If energy of photons increased, the maximum kinetic energy of electrons increased. As the maximum kinetic energy of electrons increases, stopping potential also increases. Means at a more negative potential than the previous one, the electrons are stopped, means photocurrent increase, photocurrent becomes zero. In the same way, as you increase the frequency again to nu 3 value, here nu 2 greater than nu 1, we increase the frequency further to nu 3, which is nu 3 greater than nu 2, and we keep the intensity same. As we increase again frequency, energy of photons increases, maximum kinetic energy of electrons released increases. As maximum kinetic energy of electrons increases, stopping potential also increases. So that as a stopping potential is increased to V0 3 value. Now from this it is clear that the stopping potential is just depending on the frequency of the incident radiation, but it does not depend on the intensity of incident radiation. The stopping potential as well as the maximum kinetic energy of the electrons, both these two depends only on the frequency of the incident radiation, but these two does not depend upon the intensity of the incident radiation. Whatever the intensity, just these maximum kinetic energy and stopping potential depends on the frequency of the incident radiation only.